Call me the new vision of Obama. And I'll be rooted like, oh, na-na. Oh, watch your serenade, Mick Barker. And I'm just like, oh, na-na. Boom, bada, you stop away the tic tac. Everybody just shouting, oh, na-na. Hello,
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 hello.
Welcome to Kutsime.
We meet, we talk. I'm Becky.
I'm Natasha.
I'm Honey Boo Boo.
This is a show with women, but for the people, and we discuss all things pertaining to life. Here's what to look forward to. Hot topics with my girl, Honey Boo Boo. And Noxy, our outside correspondent, who brings in all the juice for the topic that we are discussing. Also, an expert's view on the topic at hand. And we have Chuck's take. This is a man's perspective on the topic that we're discussing.
Which I feel we don't really need.
Oh.
Okay then, but we are going to get his perspective on it. We ready, we good?
We're good.
All right, so let's get into it. For the past years, a certain couple infiltrated our lives, our workspaces, our homes, churches, like everywhere, guys.
Social media pages,
like we were just juicing up them bundles just to hear the story, because infidelity was the topic at hand. But I mean, like, who's not unfaithful? Guys, now it has been recorded that over 2,600 couples filed for a divorce in 2017 alone in Zimbabwe.
No way.
I promise you.
Lie.
I promise you. But now the stats as they stand, it's a little bit expensive to get divorced, so those numbers are dropping.
That's an excuse.
All right, I mean, like, look at it this way. You have built an empire, a legacy with this guy, and then he feels itchy for a couple of minutes, he goes and gets a scratch, and then you find out, are you going to break down what you have worked so hard to build because he felt itchy for 5 minutes?
Because he felt itchy for 5 minutes is because he's with me. That's when it's fun.
Okay.
Okay. But right. Am I willing to split what I worked hard
Hell
for?
Hell no.
Okay.
No.
Calm down.
No. We're not splitting nothing. My hard-earned money. Mm-hmm. You think you're entitled to it. No, we'll stay together, separated, open relationship, whatever works.
No way, honey.
You are not in getting entitled to my money.
All right, so this is what has happened in most couples. So most couples would rather stay married in secretly.
Me?
You know, they're like divorced, separated, and it's like, yeah, we're neither here nor there. It's a slippery slope.
I think Honey Boo Boo and I will keep
in
it
your
like
money.
This.
You're keeping your money?
Yes.
You and Honey Boo Boo will keep it?
We'll keep it like this. Honey Boo Boo, show them. Show them the hand. No. Yeah.
I'm right here, guys. Like, till death do us part.
Yeah. Someday. When infidelity stops.
When infidelity stops. Now, also, stats have also proved that men invented the game, but the women seem to be, you know, spinning the table and doing it a little bit better.
Because
the men.
Because we can. Hey, Honey Boo Boo.
Amen to that.
I can't believe
we
I'm
are
actually
perfecting
sitting
the game, ladies.
I can't believe I'm actually
we
sitting
are perfecting.
With you ladies right now, and you're actually agreeing that women are perfecting this game.
Okay, stop acting like my Mfundisi, please.
My Mfundisi, hallelujah.
Let's get to basics. Women can play the game 99.9% better than a man.
Right, so but then what's the reason behind a woman then being unfaithful in the we know men, you know,
stamina.
Men are just men. They see the chicken, but you know they've got beef at home and they want chicken, so they'll go for the chicken,
stamina.
But I've got the beef at home. But with the woman,
stamina.
Why then
stamina.
What's your
So I've been told.
I think there's two reasons to that. I think, well, number one is you could just be married to a serial cheater.
Mm-hmm.
Or there's an issue missing at home. Either it's the bedroom.
But
go on.
I just feel, you know, even if there's issues at home, you said for better or for worse. So when worse kicks in, that's when loyalty should kick in as well.
Say it louder. Even when one of the biggest issues is finance?
Even when one of the biggest issues is finance?
We'll thug it out.
I thought it was my...
Taura, honey, we want to hear your comment.
Taura,
Hunzwi.
Speak, we want to hear your comment because...
I just said for better or for worse.
Okay, here's a scenario. Serial cheat and you're broke. You going to stay?
Nah.
I don't think so either.
Nah.
Exactly. So we also had Noxy go out in the streets to figure out what is really happening with these couples and being unfaithful, because we've got the saga of the side chicks, we've got the saga of the bentens, and then we've got the saga of, you know what, guys, I'm just cheating, I'm not happy, and this is how it's going down. You had something to say about bentens the other day when we were talking about the bentens. What was... It was bentens and small houses. To small houses.
Okay.
What was it that you picked up on?
So I think we were worried mainly about the small houses, how they're coping during lockdown. Like, really, guys, tell us, how are you coping during
because
lockdown?
Because Mr. Man, are you guys eating? Why are you being horrible? Okay, because now they're stuck with, okay, the man is stuck with my guru, and he'll be hitting phone calls like, what is he saying? Like, like, they can't even talk. They can't be as open as they were because lockdown has them on lockdown. So we're going to hear from Noxy, and she's going to let us know what she found out on the streets. Because word on the streets is, you're still seeing each other.
What?
Even during lockdown, guys, I promise you. So take a look at what Noxy found out. Thank you, ladies. The FOMO is killing me. So next week, I'm going to make an effort to come and be with you there on the table, have coffee, gossip, do all those things. But this side of things is where the juice is. I'm joined by a beautiful, beautiful lady. And she's the other woman in a particular marriage. Rose?
Hello.
I'm going to jump straight into it. As a young woman who's not married, when I'm dating, what I'm thinking is, I want to build a life with this person. I want to have a home. I want to get married, have kids. You are the other woman in a relationship. What got you into that type of a situation?
Well, Pektanga, dancing as a bit of a chatter.
Okay.
Takango, ni introduce ko, ni shamari tango. And then I later discovered it.
And then why didn't you leave when you discovered?
I have bills to pay.
Wow.
I also want a comfortable life.
Okay. And how long have you been seeing this guy for?
For 2 years.
Don't you ever get affected by the fact that as women, I think generally as people, you know, you want someone to go back home to at the end of the day, even if it's that, like, got 10 o'clock text where like, babe, I miss you, or it's cuddles. Doesn't that affect you?
It does sometimes, but he makes up for it.
How?
Holidays.
You go on holidays with him, or he sends you on holidays?
I go with him.
Okay.
Yes. But most of the times, if I feel like going somewhere, he just sends me.
Do you love him?
I like him. I like his company.
After 2 years, you just like him and you like his company?
Yes.
If he were to leave his wife, do you see yourself being with him?
No.
Wow. We just heard from Rose, who's the other woman, in quotes, the small house. And I'm going to be getting into a conversation with a Ben 10, something I'm really looking forward to, you know? I'm looking forward to that conversation. This is Kutsime, We Meet, We Talk. Tafazo, thank you for joining me on Kutsime, We Meet, We Talk. You are in a relationship with an older woman. So as we start this conversation, I want to know just how big is your age difference? No, I mean, we're having a conversation. I want to know just how much older than you she is.
I think funny difference here, about 15 years.
And how old are you?
27.
So that makes her 42. Where did you meet this lady?
She's my boss, Kwado Shand.
Wow. Who initiated the relationship?
So Kupanaka initiated the relationship. Taishanda tese my late nights bus. So Shanda tese bus now and Wakawanda. She's running with the cause.
So is it safe to say she's the one who's sustaining the relationship financially?
She's Jinji, the one who bada.
And you're okay with it?
And don't bonus, no pressure.
You don't feel like it takes away how men are supposed to be providers and?
No, she's more financially stable. She can afford to pay, so let her pay. I don't have any problem with that.
Okay, do you have a girlfriend?
Yes. Your age.
Nice.
And how's that relationship working out, considering you have to balance two relationships? Okay, so where do you see this relationship with your girlfriend going? And what's going to happen now, moms?
I would like to take it to Pandora's canal, which is a boss and the Panta Garcia.
Kobaza boy, safe here.
I think we're going to be
safe. I mean, we have to talk about it. All right, so where do you hang out with this woman?
Well, I usually after bars, I clean down my hotels, then my weekends, punish my bars, my dad's usually.
So your plan is to end that relationship when you're marrying your girlfriend? Wow, Tafanzwa, all the best.
Thank you.
that's all I can say, all the best.
Thank you.
All right then. So I'm joined by Gladys. Gladys, you're having an extramarital affair, and I really appreciate you taking time out to come and actually have this conversation with me. How long have you been married for?
I've been married for, it's been 13 years now.
13?
Yeah.
And how long has your affair been going on for?
For 5.
How did that affair start?
My husband is a businessman. Okay. And he travels a lot. And it's actually his friend.
Wow.
Because he would come to the house, help a lot with...
So he's a familiar face?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's a familiar face. And when my husband was away, it just developed into something new.
Do you love him?
I love my husband.
No, but I mean, you've been seeing this man for 5 years. Do you love him?
We seem to have come to an agreement. Mm-hmm. I understand that he's not going to leave his wife for me.
Uh-huh.
And I'm not going to leave my husband for him.
Okay.
So, love, I mean, I have feelings for him,
uh-huh.
But I don't know if I can call those feelings love.
Okay, so I'm going to step into your bedroom a little bit, okay? You, in the event that you have to hang out with your boyfriend, say you guys are hanging out in the afternoon and things get a little kinky and freaky,
yeah.
And you get home in the evening and your husband expects that you guys have to have sex. Do you do it?
Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. It's not a response, Gladys. Do you do it?
Yes.
Wow.
Not on a regular, but yes.
Okay. Do you have kids?
My husband and I have 3 children. 2 are my husband's.
Wait a minute. When you say 2 are your husband's, it means... one of the kids is not his.
One of my children is my partner's.
Wow. And you plan to keep this relationship up for how long?
It's not something we've sat down and decided what should happen.
But there's
next.
A child involved now.
My partner doesn't know either.
Wow.
I didn't tell him. I felt it would complicate things.
And you knew it was your partner's child how?
Calculations. I couldn't have gotten pregnant by my husband. He wasn't around.
Okay. I'm shocked. But thank you very much for coming through and sharing your story. That was Gladys, was having an extramarital affair. And, well, for now, my shock and I are directing you back to the studio with the beautiful girls.
Hey guys, welcome back to Kutsime. We meet, we talk. We're just coming back from Noxy's Corner with some very, very interesting stories, which I personally can't wait to hear my girl's thoughts on.
I'm still trying to gather my thoughts at this point. Like, I'm still in shock. Like, I can't believe that the streets are wild like that.
Wilding, serious wilding. Oof. On the streets. The one that stood out for me was the married woman, and then hubby is traveling. And then you feel like hubby's friend is more available, so I'm gonna get a piece of hubby's friend. Mm. Hubby's friend, Eddie. Hubby's friend. You know
that
what? I understand.
Just don't do.
Yeah.
Like my mind, not close to home, guys.
That's a suicide attempt. There's a child involved.
What happens when the child gets hurt and you need
DNA,
blood,
you need blood,
a bone marrow?
I'd kill her personally.
You know?
Honestly, because I'm not saying cheating's right, but I feel there's cheating do's and don'ts. You get what I'm saying?
I agree with you, honey, don't mess where you eat.
Honestly, just don't like, mess
just,
where you eat.
Just pour in the dirt friend. In the well.
Like this, there, this is you. Men you could go
and
play
then you do
with.
These. This
really, right on your doorstep? Honey.
A whole child and their school fees.
School fees, medical aid, plus to make it worse, you're paying now in USD. Mm.
And you've been playing, hello, Nana. Daddy, shush. No, guys, I will kill you.
I eat it.
But the one that was kind of fun, though, the nigga seemed to be like a little bit organized. Yeah. The Ben 10. Now he's got his eggs in a row. He's sorted.
That's a businessman.
That's a businessman.
I wish I had my hat. I would take my hat off to that young man.
And did he?
Yeah.
No, hat off. Hat off, but it's wrong still. But
at least he's
off.
Getting Rora for the woman he really, really loves.
With whose money?
With Bay's money.
Hello.
He's using Bay's
money. Bay is paying the Rora.
Yes.
For the my nini.
Well. Yeah, but he for works for it, yeah, okay. Technically.
He works for it.
Technically.
Like, but that just makes you think, like, in the workplaces, what is really going on? Boss lady, can you please come to my office?
You know it's about to go down.
You're in a meeting and he's under the desk, man.
Oh, come on. Ah, Tasha, no. All right. And then we've got the side chick. Do you love him? Did you see how Noxy was like so into there and she's trying to figure out,
and like,
I want to know if you love him.
She couldn't answer.
Honey boo boo, do you love him? How would you answer? It's either yes or no. And
yeah.
Okay, let's role play. So, honey, boo boo, you've got this guy. Do you love him?
No.
Okay, thank you. Let's role play. Natasha, you've got this guy. Do you love him? And then there was a moment of
silence.
There
was no comment.
There was no comment. Like, I like his company. Like, we all know what she likes there.
Like, I like his money.
Thank you.
Basically,
she should have just said, I like his money. But again, these are side chicks with a plan. Because Tunova Ziranga, my side chick.
I don't think she had a plan because she didn't say much.
And no, I think that's a side chick with a degree.
With a degree. She said she was getting her rent paid. So clearly, rent was more of an issue for her.
But she did say due to like how the economy is at this point, it's a bit hectic.
Ma one. But we did say earlier on that we were worried about them because what would you get?
Imagine, like, during lockdown.
What you going to be doing now during lockdown?
Running out of bleaching cream, running out of chingwa.
Tasha,
no,
you are just like,
nah,
you are not playing, you're not playing fair. So ladies, I'm just saying, after seeing all those stories, what are we concluding? What are we saying? Like, it's happening. We can't hide away from it.
True.
Yeah, the streets are wild.
The streets are dirty.
Hella wild.
After seeing that, I'm like scared to get married now because...
What, like, do you mean you're scared to get married?
No, you have a whole ring. You said yes. What are you scared of?
I said I'm scared of getting married. I didn't say I wasn't going to get married.
That's someone who's scared to get married, guys.
I did, didn't I?
But it's just a scary feeling to know that the person whom you've given your whole heart, your trust, your emotions to, can go out and have a whole child.
Outside of your home.
Outside of your home.
No, that's disrespectful.
That's just my, honestly, I'd hit her. Like, don't mess where you eat. Like there's plenty men. I'm not saying these are rules.
Just go for
cheating
counseling.
Rules, do's go and for don'ts.
Go for counseling.
So are you saying,
someone.
Friend.
Are you saying that it's okay to cheat, but cheat far away from home? Is that what you're saying?
Rather. No, I'm not saying do it, but I'm saying rather. Okay, let's put yourself in that position. Let's say hubby dates your friend. Mm-hmm. Your friend.
He and my friend, go and see.
But it's better, I feel it's better if it's somebody you don't know.
To be honest with you.
As compared to somebody you know.
My personal opinion on hubby dating a friend, I'd be like, really, guys, go on and have your fun.
All right, so we've been doing all the talking. Right about now, we're going to hear from Chuck's Takes. So sorry, Tasha, but we have to sit down. We're going to hear from Chuck's Takes. Stand by.
Well, okay, Chuck's Take, right. I've been listening for a couple of minutes now, and sadly, the world we live in, I feel like this Sodom and Gomorrah 2.0 coming.
Mm. Amen.
Because both parties are cheating. But what happened to the part whereby couples can actually sit down and have a discussion, as in, what I don't like mm-hmm. and what I like. Mm-hmm. When I was growing up, our folks would be married forever, but now, like you said, the divorce rate is like skyrocketing. Why? I feel there's not a lot of communication with the young couples of today.
Yeah. But do you think if communication was included, it would be better?
Communication is everything. You tell me how you want it. Mm-hmm. You get me? Then I'll give it to you how you want it. Mm. Not that at the end of the day, you don't say anything. You don't. I'm thinking I'm doing my thing, mm-hmm. but you don't say anything. Yes?
Okay. I just want to ask. Yeah. So do you think cheating is just usually about
obviously
doing the do?
No.
Is that like it only?
Communication.
There's like more to it.
Finance. Nowadays, it's more about finance.
Yeah.
You get me?
Yeah.
But
yeah.
if you're saying that the guy doesn't have that much money, how about you supporting the guy? Since you got into a marriage, it's 50-50. That's what I think, isn't it?
That's
it's 50-50.
No, it should be 100-100.
Yeah. So
everyone
end of the day,
should pitch in fairly.
It all boils down to communication. If you're going to have a long chat with your partner and since you decided to be together, to better or worse, why not sit down and have that communication and come up with a plan? That's what I think.
So Chucky says communication is key. Why not sit down with your partner and communicate the problem at hand? And Natasha went, Honey Boo Boo was on her. Tell us what you think in the comment section. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
My name is Pastor Grace Kapswara, and I am a marriage coach. I do so much of marriage counseling. We've been doing that for almost 20 years now. Now, I have heard the girls talking about the issue of infidelity, and then I said, wow, that is so me, because I love dealing with such issues. Listen, infidelity has been taken as something that is rather minor nowadays, but there is something that a lady who experienced it explained it to me, and then I say, wow, this thing must be deep. So she says to me, Pastor Grace, when you experience infidelity, your spouse in marriage going with another woman or with another man, she says to me that, Pastor Grace, it is deeper than death, because with death, at least you know that your partner is gone. But with infidelity, they are there, and you're trying to make things, and you're asking yourself that, what is it exactly what I have done wrong? I think the most important thing is to come out, say it as it is, and then you begin to find a ground where you both agree that, okay, fine, if this caused it, then what guidelines are we taking to try to render powerless the things that caused that infidelity? But then sometimes it's not easy, because look, especially with women, they'll tell the men, tell me the truth, how was it? And there's some questions which I tell women that don't ask him, because unonzwamuna chiti saka uyu I gonna say, I mean, can I be real? So I mean, like, punishment, because then what? You know, if you learn that maybe she moved in a certain way more than you, I mean, there are some details which are not necessary. So in part of the healing and solution making, sometimes you need to be so deliberate about it and say, look, it has come to the open. This person has been honest with me that this is what they have done. But avoiding details can also be healing. And then we just pray to God that the rate of infidelity that we are experiencing goes down. But then, of course, with the dynamics which we are experiencing nowadays, the financial thing, according to research, what breaks off marriages mostly is that financial aspect and that emotional need. My take is, as a couple, just learn to be as open to each other as possible, Now, set at disadvantages of that is that sometimes in different cultures, maybe wives are told to fear men, and sometimes you're not as open, and even maybe in bed, you don't want to really discuss. Because if you say that you're not holding me properly there, then they'll be like, "Wakasusira kupi," or "Where did you know that from?" But then be open to each other, and the rest will be really secondary issues.
Remember to continue the conversation with us on our social media platforms. Thank you so much to Pastor Grace Kapswara for her view on the topic. Now, ladies, there were a few things as she was talking that irked me. I was like sitting at the edge of my seat and I'm like, no, woman of God, what if I want the details? I understand where she's coming from, that the details may harm you, but I want to know.
No, I want
to know, what was she doing that I wasn't doing?
No.
Maybe I wasn't, you know.
No, Becky,
okay,
no.
Okay, that's a bit too much now. That will scar you for life, Mama. Scar you.
How do I handle it then?
Mm-hmm. You need to decide as a person, do I keep it moving or do I live knowing that my man's is out there with someone else every other day?
Well, I personally chose to just leave.
Mm.
Oh. You get what I'm saying? Like, just left.
Okay, can I ask?
Of course.
Did he decide to put up a chena? Or did you have to, like, catch him?
Sad to say, namubata chita nye nye nye
tsake. No way.
I swear.
Nye 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 nye.
Do you want us to pray?
Maybe just a little.
Lord Jesus. All right, so then what's the way forward with this? Because I'm going to be having this thing bugging me the whole time.
As Honey Boo Boo and I suggested to you, you never ever ask details because that is just going to haunt you.
Yes.
Never asked.
You're always going to have it in the back of your mind, oh, she did this better than me.
Yeah.
When you see her walking past or walking, you'll be like, she did that better than me.
She cooked better than you. She cleaned better than you. She
dressed better than you. Okay, I get it.
Okay.
She's prettier than you.
No, okay, stop.
Oh, no. The famous one is, every time I get home, you're nagging.
Oh, that's a famous one.
Yeah. Every time I get home, you're nagging. I'm coming from work. I need to eat. I'm this, but you're there. Yep. No.
Who's
not
coming from work? Who's not looking after your kids? Who's not cleaning the house?
Hello?
Are you in agreement with us now?
Let's talk after the show. I'm sure we can, like, you know, come to an agreement point. Okay, yeah. Now we've seen and heard how we deal with infidelity issues in Zimbabwe.
Now you need to get a load of this. In the Philippines, men and women who have sex with someone other than their spouse could face jail time. So does the person they cheat with.
Sounds like the same story happening in Indonesia. The Sharia law forbids adultery. Like, no, not happening here. If someone is caught, they could go to jail for up to 9 months. Like, a whole baby is born.
Yo, I'll get a load of this. For each adulterous act in Taiwan, you're sentenced to 4 months in jail.
Mm-mm.
The law has been criticized for being archaic.
South Dakota is one of 7 U.S. states that still has alienation of affection laws that allow a married person who was cheated on to sue the other man or woman their partner had an affair with.
Moving from South Dakota, going on to Egypt, women can face up to 2 years in prison for adultery, but men, for the same crime, only serve 6 months.
You're joking.
6 months. Chuck, why? Why?
It's very simple. Women tend to cheat with emotions. You guys are a bit conniving. You plot and you scheme and you know exactly what you're doing.
Right.
Men, we are hunters. We're lustful creatures. We just see and we like and we take. You know?
So you're saying a longer sentence for motive?
Not really. But I'm saying, well, this is Egypt, by the way. They have their own laws.
Right.
You get me?
Yeah.
Other countries have their laws, as you said earlier on. But this is Egypt, so I would move to Egypt.
Of course you would, Chucks.
I'd burn Egypt.
You're burning Egypt. I'm moving to South Dakota. Like, US, here I come. Stay with us. When we come back, we get Hot Topics in 60 with Honey Boo Boo.
And it's hot, guys. Stay tuned. And we're back. This is Hot Topics in 60 with your girl, Honey Boo Boo. So today on Hot Topics, Vanchoga has decided to let go of his management in a dramatic exit. Yala Nation made him sign out right in the middle of the CBD and literally tore up his contract. Still, on the dancehall scene, the gaffer himself, Winky D, the biggie man, was on heat for delivering a performance that was somewhat questionable considering his standards. Critics are now claiming it was sabotage. Was it? Was it really? Or did they just drop the ball completely? Our very own Shasha scooped us our first BET award. Okay. Now the word on the street is our beloved South Africans are now claiming her as their own. We thought it's necessary to put it on record that she is wholly and completely Zimbabwean, and we are proud of our own. We are happy to share them. And in studio with us today, we have Mr. Whistle, Andy Muridzu.
Where Muridzu?
Look at the welcome, welcome.
What's up?
Makadiba
Bakaketo. Oh, cool. Makadiba
Bakaketo. You know, Farah, we are happy you're here. We're happy to have you.
Oh, okay. I'm very proud to be sitting next to Halala Amanda.
Amanda!
Okay, sitting. What about me standing?
I'm just playing. All right, so we've got Andy Muridzu in studio. He's going to be performing for us as we shut the show down. But before we do that, how about we play a little game?
Okay.
You ready for it?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, even if you're not ready, you're going to play the game anyway. Tasha?
Okay, so the game is about whatever word we mention, you then tell us what comes to mind.
Yeah.
Are you game?
Even if it's a name to like Natasha.
Anything that comes to mind. All right, Andy, behave yourself. Okay. All right, so the first word all up in here is women.
Women. Confusion.
Tricky.
That's
friends.
Disaster.
Oh, snap.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay. Oh my goodness. Shade.
All right. Infidelity.
Slay queen.
Okay. All right. No, it's cool. It's cool.
Okay. We see you. We see you. Zimbabwe.
Copycat.
Okay. And the final word, money.
Evil.
Oh my goodness.
You know what, okay. Andy?
Honestly.
Andy, you were not playing fair, but that's okay. I mean, because we did say, the first word we say, you let us know what comes to mind. Yeah. So we were talking about infidelity today. What's your take on that topic?
What I can just say is like, you know what?
All right, he needs to.
Let me take a sip before
okay,
I say
okay, he needs some water because it's about to get real right now. Andy, your name has been dragged through a lot of issues to do with infidelity, so we would really like to know your take on this topic.
Do you have an example like of what was mentioned about my
infidelity? Do you want us to go there? Can you just comment on the issue? Let's go.
What I can say on that is I'm not a cheater.
Okay.
You heard it. Pardon? I didn't
you
get that.
You heard it.
And okay, I'm louder. Not a cheater.
So what
you're
are
not
you?
A cheater.
Yeah.
Okay. So where do the stories come from, though? Because according to me, there's no smoke without fire.
Wherever there's talent, there's
There's haters.
There's haters.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. You guys. He had the ball, and Joe were like, you need to take the ball from him.
Exactly.
All right. So where do you stand with the issue right now?
With the cheating issue. I think I'm just sipping to it. Like.
Okay.
Alrighty then. So as Andy Muridzu takes a sip on that, he will be getting ready to perform for us as he shuts the show down. Mr. Muridzu, are you ready?
Very.
All right.
I was
so
born
you,
ready.
He was born ready. Yeah. So you can head on over to Studio A where he will be performing with Shabak. The band.
Ah, the band.
The band.
I'm just gonna let this handsomeness love you and leave you guys.
Take your handsomeness next
Thank
door,
you
man.
For coming.
So as Andy is getting ready to shut the show down for us, this has been an amazing first episode for us.
Honestly, it's been so much fun.
I literally enjoyed myself. Thank you, ladies. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Oh,
girl power. Girl power all the way. So now back to our topic. We just discovered that infidelity, there's really no way to deal with it. You just have to learn to live with it.
Or kill him.
And bury him.
Okay, so learn to live with it, kill him or bury him. You guys need to come and save me from these ladies. Alrighty then, so from the crew behind the scenes, this is Kutsime.
We meet.
We talk.
I'm Becky.
I'm Natasha.
I'm Honey Boo Boo.
Bye.
My name is Andy Marizzo, aka Baba Keketon, and Shambam the Band. Kutsime episode 1. If you're African, proud, raise your hands in the air. Nobuti, Zaganyanya. Bazooka, Bazoo, Bazoo. I see the light at the end of the tunnel. I see freedom. I hear the voices from the nation. There's a shouting, calling Wakanda. I see the light. I hear the waves. I hear the voices from the water. Africa! Africa! Say the Zulu and the Xhosa, they're just shouting Ubuntu. I see the Shona and the Ndebele, Tino Taura, Tichiti Hundu. Swahili, Lingala, oh oh, Nakupenda. We say Igbo, Kili, that's the language from Nigeria. We say the Chewa and the Nyacha, that's the language from Malawi, Lobale, Lochazi, that's Zambia. Africa! 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 Just guide us. Oh, Africa, let just stand as one and sing Hakuna Matata. Mama Africa, yo yo yo. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Africa, Africa, yo. Africa. Once again, my name is Andy Marizzo, aka Baba Keketo, Shambak the Band, Ugasha.